Hi, this is Jennifer Bagley with CI Web Group, and recently we had a request to do a website analysis and have been asked to record this video for activefirm.com. On the left-hand side, you'll see the physical site. On the right-hand side, you'll see the website. And first of all, I just have to say thank you for giving me a site that is very, very visually appealing. I get requested to do a tremendous amount of sites, and it's really nice to see something that has such a beautiful visual appeal. So I love the design of the site. I like the tips and suggestions. I like the beauty vaults, the calls to actions. I love that you have a poll on the site to be able to get people's input. Looks like you guys are using Poll Daddy. I like the ability to connect with your social media networks, to search the site. From a design standpoint, as a very first view of the site, I'm pleasantly surprised, very happy. Customer service number right at the top, login number right at the top, integrated shopping cart, love it. Very clean navigation. There are going to be design experts, people that are, that's what they do, and that's not me. I'm a design consumer, so I just happen to be in the business of looking at sites. So my opinion is noticeably not perfect on the design, but as a consumer and someone who looks at a lot of websites, great job, great job. You've made my morning to be able to take a look at a site that's well done design-wise. So I just said the other day, I said, I wish I got a site review that was submitted that was for a visually appealing site. So I like it. All right, now let's get to the where my specialties lie, which is really the infrastructure and so forth. First thing, I'm going to go in and do a quick inspect element, grab your code, and let's go see what we have going on. Right off the bat, I can see you have cascading style sheets. Nicely done. That's great. I also can see that you guys are using WordPress and you're using a theme-based system. So your WordPress actually has a brain. Love it. You're using WP eCommerce as the primary commerce platform. That's a great e-commerce system that works for small businesses. With WP eCommerce, it looks like you have the majority of the necessary plugins. You got Lightbox, you got their Gold Card plugin, the related post plugin, you got the UI portion. Nice job putting together all of the different e-commerce plugins. Full W3, you got the core. You have all the jQuery plugins. Nice, nice, and nice. Whoever did this did a really good job of putting together all the different technology. And putting together all the technology, I think it looks really good. Let's see here. Now I'm just looking around. WP Polls. Okay, so you're using WP Polls. It's good. Thixbox plugin. Nice. Good stuff. All right, let me jump out of now. So this is cool because, you know, I always talk about websites being built in layers. So you have the engine, you have the architecture, you have the framework, you have the interior body of a car. So think about it like a car. You have all these different components, and you guys have nailed the majority of them. So now this is a cool situation, and I like working in this space. Because this is where we really excel, and this is where you can really excel. So we're going to go through this site. You've got everything that you need from a functionality standpoint. I love it. Goodness. Nice. Okay. Let's see here. No div, crazy tables, no crazy containers. I don't see any Z indexes. They've done a good job of using the theme logic to be able to modify the theme. Nice. Polls. Nice gallery. So you okay? Laziest gallery. That's your slideshow program. That's good. I'm almost done. Let me just finish going through here real quick and kind of see what we have going on. All right. So I kind of stopped when we got to the metadata information, which we'll see as we go through the site. Thank you for giving me a nice site to look at. I love it. All right, now let's go through and see how we can help take it to the next level, which that's the goal. Everybody wants to have the opportunity to keep growing and growing and growing and take something that's at par and bring it up to greatness and greatness up to mastery and so forth. So this is a good progress. All right, website itself grades 84 out of 100, and let's go through and we'll kind of pinpoint what and why. First things first, 84 is a great initial if you have a brand new site with good SEO, good platform, and so forth, the right type of infrastructure. This is a good place to start. So now, blog analysis. You do have a blog integrated into the site. Let's see what you have going on with that. And go. All right, so here's the blog, and that is actually what is being called the Beauty Vault, which I like that. Let's see if we can get this to go evaluate just the blog. From what I can tell, because you guys are new online, you probably don't have a lot of blog content. One thing you need to do right away is in your navigation, you do need to put a link to the primary top level category called blog. While you guys call it the Beauty Vault, there's going to be a large population of people who are familiar with looking for a blog on a website and being able to subscribe to that via RSS. So first two things you got to get done right away is log in, take your primary category, which you do have set up called blog, go to your menu structure, add in your menu structure, top level menu structure, the word blog. Also, on the very front of the site, you can either do it at the in the lower right-hand corner under Connect. You need to have a subscription place where they can subscribe your RSS feed. So I know that from a branding standpoint, we've used a lot of icons that all match the flavor of the site, the green kind of eco look. But I'm going to recommend for your RSS feed subscription, stick to the orange RSS icon. I don't want people to get mistaken. I don't want them to bypass it or not see it because they're looking for a place to subscribe and they just can't because it's not in the normal visible appearance that they're used to looking at on site. So knock those two things out real quick. Let me look into the blog now. Couple things. When you get into the blog, you're going to have two different audiences when you are adding content to the site. So you guys are in the right frame of mind as far as adding content to the site. One audience is going to be real people. The title, Food for Thought, and this particular article is designed for social media, is designed for real people. However, this isn't going to help you from a search engine standpoint. It's too generic, not a searchable phrase. It's not something people are looking for. It doesn't have anything to do with your keywords. Isn't going to help you from a density standpoint. So you have to make sure that your website serves two purposes. One, speaking to real people through leveraging social media and so forth. And two, you also have to attract Google. And that is, you're going to get into a totally different frame of mind. Usually someone who is great at graphics design is not great at the engineering side of the site. So my company, we tend to be really, really good at the engineering component, and we love working with people who are great with graphics design because they're just more visually appealing. So and it's normally not in the same person. So that's something to consider. From an on-page optimization standpoint for your blog is going to be a really important component to your website being able to perform. So you've got to learn how to be able to create a post that is going to assist you in generating new traffic. So things like page titles, permalinks. You'll notice your permalink up here is activefarm.com/blog/food for thought. Again, we got to keep your permalink structure and those page titles in primary phrase or primary key phrase words. Instead of using food for thought, let me just scan this article real quick. So if it's important for you to be searched for vitamins, you've got some things about vitamins. You have some things about what are the valuable vitamin sources from a pumpkin. Now it may be bride pins. Let's see here. Maybe how to eliminate stress during the holidays. It might be focusing on the breakouts and so forth. So this article really, because there's so many different varied topics within this article, this is really just good for social media. What I would do is I would take this article and I would break this article into primary phrases. Remember, one thought, one phrase, one page. One thought, one page. One thought, one page. So you're going to want to have one page that's specifically talking about problems with breakouts. You're going to have one page that's specifically talking about stress during the holidays. One page that's specifically talking about, let's see here, dry and irritated skin. Another page that's going to be, and I'm looking at these in your content, another one that's dark under eye circles. Another one that is something about wrinkles. Another one is going to be about vitamins and so forth. So one page, one thought. When you cram all this into one particular letter, which I love the letter for people, you don't get any search engine value. So if you revise what this article is doing for you and break it into those different components and really heavily optimize those posts, then now you're looking at generating new traffic and from people who are looking for something specific, like a remedy for dark circles under your eyes. So next thing, learning how to optimize content is going to be very important. You've got this kick butt system, this awesome platform, this website, integrated blog, integrated social media, you have all these things inside of it. So now you got to learn how to drive this car because you're driving a Lamborghini now, which is awesome. And that's going to really have to do with understanding how to format the content, as well as on-page and off-page strategies that are going to help you get found. So internally, you guys need to come up with a schedule. Your success is going to come from, one, do you have the right technology? Two, do you have the right strategy? So we were just talking about strategy. That's important. Three, do you have the right processes in place? So let me give you an example of a process. When you add a blog post to your website, is your website automatically submitting that blog post out to your social media network? So let's go do a real quick check and see if it is. We'll go jump into your Facebook page, and we have food for thought. So this looks like you guys actually went back to your website, copied the link, and pasted the link in your site. Well, that's a good practice. The only challenge with that is it's time consuming and operationally not very efficient. So a portion of your website needs to be geared towards increasing your marketing effectiveness, but a huge portion of your website needs to be geared towards operational enhancements and effective strategies to be able to give you more time. And that time can be dedicated to more revenue generating activities. Let's go look at Twitter. And on Twitter, I don't see integration with the site. So those are procedurally two things that you can do that are really going to help you improve your results. All right. And the last component, so we went through the technology, the strategy, the process. And then the last component is going to be the behavior, which is your interaction with the technology, the frequency of it, and how you're leveraging these things. So we're going to go through and look at page titles and so forth. So we have about our founder, our people, our innovation, ingredients. Let's go look about Actifirm and then ingredients. We have a very nice database in here. This is beautifully done. Whoever did this did a really good job. Let's see here. Let me go. What are we looking at? What did they use? So they did input, and this is fine. This is what's been done is they basically took a table and put it into the site. So no biggie. It's not a big deal. Just remember the phrases that you have inside this table. The table is not huge asset to the site from Google's standpoint, very visually appealing to real people. However, the content that is inside this table could be extremely valuable to your business from a search engine standpoint. So my recommendation is what you are going to want to do, instead of hiding all of this great valuable content inside a table, you're going to want to take each one of these particular phrases. So shiitake mushroom helps with skin firming. That's your new blog post. So you need to have a blog post, shiitake mushroom helps with skin firming. That needs to be the page title, the excerpt. It needs to be heavily used or densely used within the content. It needs to be your meta title within your description at least twice, and it needs to have different variations of that same phrase between 5 to 7 times on each post. Additionally, you need to have interlinks. So at least every 100 words, you want to have the word shiitake or mushroom or skin firming. You want to have a different page within the site that it's going to be linking to that other phrase. So that's called interior linking, which is going to be important as well. All right, we'll go through the next area. Moisturizers and serums. So this is within your actual WP shopping cart. This is actually a good platform, good SEO, you can tell from the top. Your permalink structure is good. Header tags are good. This should be an H2 tag. So those are H3s. The top one is an H2. You can see it down here in the right here. That's perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Good integration with social media, the ability to like, the ability to share, as well as a rating system. So awesome integration. Let's go through. Page titles look great. So overall, there's a few things you can do, obviously, from strategy with implementing your blog. However, the development of the site was very, very well done. You've got 117 index pages, so making sure that you have a goal to increase those pages over time is going to be critical. Now, getting into the metadata information on the site, basically the site has very little optimization done on it. When you get into on-page search engine optimization and off-page search engine optimization, that's your hugest area for improvement. But the cool part is you have the right technology. Most of the sites that I get asked to review, they don't have the right technology to even think about investing in search engine optimization, even though sometimes they do. So you are in a much better position. Getting into a very good on-page optimization, content distribution plan, as well as an off-page backlinking program is where you need to concentrate 100% of your energy. You guys have 8 years online. Domain doesn't expire for 3 years. You've got a 301 redirect. That's awesome. Google's got you with the page rank of 4. 4 out of 10 is really low for being online 8 years, but I don't know what your site looked like before this, so you probably have a little bit of recovery to do from your past site. Your backlinks are great. You've got a lot of authoritative pages that are linking back to you, so it's not a bunch of junk backlinks. Mobile optimization, you got a couple things that need fixed, but that's easy, especially within the WordPress framework. Social media integration, that's great. People have the ability to follow you. People have the ability to share, the ability to like. The only thing that I don't see is happening is your site doesn't seem to be connected through APIs to all the social media sites for social media publishing. So that's a quick and easy fix. RSS feeds, conversion forms. Now, your site, because you have the right technology, if you are implementing an SEO program on page and off page, where you are going to need to concentrate your efforts is going to be on conversions. Generating a ton of traffic doesn't bring you money. Generating traffic that converts into new customers, that's what's going to impact the bottom line and create cash flow for the business. So that's where you need to concentrate your efforts, on-page SEO, off-page SEO, and then a conversion strategy. So that's where you're going to get into calls to actions on the site. I hope, if not, your website is has got to be linked into some type of a CRM system. So if people are if they're buying, if they're asking questions, if they're communicating, if they're participating within the site, that it's going into some type of management system. So overall, everything looks good. Traffic's a little bit low, but you guys have the right platform, so you're in a good position to increase that. Nice site. This overall, great site. So jump on the post-live activities of SEO and conversion marketing and get into a really, really good training program, and you guys are going to be golden. So I appreciate the opportunity to take a look at your site. If you need any help, please don't hesitate to let us know, and we look forward to talking to you soon. Again, Jennifer Bagley with CI Web Group, and I look forward to seeing you online.